Let us see an important law, which is Newton's law of viscosity in this video. Newton's law of viscosity. Newton's law of viscosity states that the shear stress is directly proportional to rate of change of shear strain. Rate of change of shear strain. So what is rate of change of shear strain? This this theta is the change in angle . So if there is a shear stress applied here, there will be change in these particles. In time t, there is theta movement of these particles. So this is for theta, the rate of change of, and this is shear strain. And the rate of change of shear strain is d theta by dt. So let us consider a plate is placed on this fluid. There is a fluid and a plate is placed on this. It is pulled with a force F. So there will be a profile formed like this. Initially, the particles are at this state, and due to application of force F, the velocity will be like this. So here there will be zero velocity. This is no slip condition. We have seen in the last video. This is no slip condition. And this travels with a velocity. The plate travels with a velocity u. And let us say this is x axis and this is y axis. The distance, this is the thickness of the fluid layer, and this is the function of u is equal to function of y. And let us derive this. So tau is directly proportional to shear stress. Shear stress is directly proportional to shear strain rate. So this is in case of liquids, and shear stress directly proportional to shear strain. This is in case of solids. This is liquids and gases. And also it is given that tau is directly proportional to velocity gradient. So if we remove this proportionality constant, we get mu into du by dy. This mu is called viscosity, or dynamic viscosity, or absolute viscosity. And this is called velocity gradient. Velocity gradient. And tau can be written as force by area, the applied force divided by area. This plate has some area like this. The surface area which is on the liquid is the area. F pi A is equal to mu into du by dy. So mu can be written as tau divided by du by dy. from this we can write units as mu is equal to units of shear stresses Newton per meter square, and the u is meter per second divided by y is meter. So we get meter gets cancelled, and finally Newton second per meter square is the units of viscosity. This is also written as Pascal second. Newton per meter square is Pascal and there is second, which is also equal to kg per meter second. Remember all these units, and in CGS it is dyne second per centimeter square. Dyne second per centimeter square, and we call it as poise. And also 1 newton is equal to 10 power 5 dynes. So we can write 1 dyne is equal to 10 power minus 5 newton. So, or 1 newton second per meter square can be written as 10 power 5 dynes second per 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So 10 square whole square centimeter square. So 10 dyne second per centimeter square. So 1 Pascal second is equal to 10 poise. So remember these relations between dyne second per centimeter square and Newton second per centimeter square. 1 Pascal second is equal to 10 poise. And 1 poise is equal to 10 centipoise. And also there is another property based on this viscosity, which is kinematic viscosity. This kinematic viscosity is nothing but it is represented with nu is equal to mu divided by density. So this is dynamic viscosity divided by density gives us kinematic viscosity. So what will be the units of kinematic viscosity? Units are meter square per second, and in CGS it is centimeter square per second. So this 1 centimeter per square per second is called as 1 stroke. Centimeter square per second is stroke, and which is also is equal to 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. So let us see how it changes with the temperature. As temperature increases, mu decreases for liquids. As temperature increases, mu decreases and density decreases. Mu decreases and density also decreases. So mostly there will be no change in viscosity. Viscosity, no change. And for gases, as temperature increases, viscosity increases and density decreases. So numerator is increasing and denominator is decreasing. So kinematic viscosity increases rapidly. So these questions might be asked in the exam.